Salutations friends, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to share with you, as I look over at the box filled with fragrances, my Guerlain collection. As you guys know, I love Guerlain scents. They're very popular. There are some masterpieces in this line or in this from this house, and I do love to collect. So I figured I'd share with you guys my Guerlain collection, share with you my favorites, the ones I wear the most, and also let you guys know which ones I'm looking to pick up in the future. So if you'd like to learn more, then keep watching. This video will probably be on the longer side, so I'm sorry about that. And I'm pretty positive I've purchased every single one of these. Guerlain has in no way ever reached out to me and offered to send me anything, and usually I just purchase these because I do love them. Now I do have a mix of the higher end Guerlain scents, like their exclusive private line, and some of their more affordable scents. To me, Guerlain is one of those houses that's very versatile. There's literally something for everybody. Their masculine fragrances are amazing. Their feminine fragrances are amazing. They're more ready to wear. They're more avant-garde, artistic. You really can't go wrong with this house. And just because I think that doesn't mean that you'll think that. So obviously this is an opinion piece. So I really don't know where to start. So I think I'm just going to reach into the box and start grabbing. The first ones I'm going to talk to you guys about, and I need to expand this lineup for me, is Shalimar. This scent is probably one of the most like scent memory, like emotion driven scents for me. I talked about it in my scent memory video. If you guys are curious, I'll link it below. This was my grandmother's signature scent, and just my mom's memories, along with the fact that I feel robbed of not being able to have those memories with my grandmother, makes this one of the scents that I just hold very dear to my heart. I absolutely love it. I like the way it smells. I would love the way it smells even if there wasn't like emotional attachment to this scent, but there is very much a very heavy emotional attachment to this scent. And then there's also the only flanker to it I have, and I need to get more flankers of it, is Shalimar Soufflé de Parfum. This is a beautiful, wearable fragrance. I adore this scent so, so, so much. I do wear it all the time. I kind of wish I had one of the prettier bottles. I might pick up a prettier bottle just because I really like them. But Soufflé de Parfum from Shalimar is an excellent, beautiful, everyday wearable scent that's just really sexy and luscious. Next up is one of the most complimented scents in my collection. It never fails whenever I wear this scent, or just about every time I wear this fragrance, I get people reaching out to me and complimenting me. Strangers, family members, friends, random people on the street. They're like, "You smell good, girl." And this scent is just magic. And it's Terracotta Le Parfum from Guerlain. Now this one is basically like they took that scent from their bronzer Terracotta and kind of recreated it as a fragrance. I love that scent so much. I like will sit there and smell my bronzer like a crazy, just like, oh, this smells so good. And so this is just one that doesn't smell identical to it, but it does smell really close. And it's just really beautiful. It's somewhat tropical and exotic, but really wearable. It works beautifully. I think this is better for the summer. I know that they released this as part of their summer lineup, but it is rich and thick enough to work really well in fall. I do wear this year round because I live in the tropics. I think this is like my, I don't know. This is one of my favorite scents that I just reach for all the time, and I love and I love and I love and I love and I love. I cherish this scent. So this is probably, again, one of my most complimented scents and probably one of my favorite scents in general, just from my collection. I'm trying not to have this video be too long, so I'm just gonna go through these three really quick. These are beautiful scents. I love them. One of these is very underrated. So I'm just gonna go through it. I have Vol de Nuit. This is the Eau de Toilette. Beautiful fragrance. I'll be doing a review of this soon. And then we have one of the newer ones to my collection, Santal Royale. I just did a review of this a few weeks ago. Really gorgeous scent. This is a love or hate it though. Some people love it, some people hate it. I'm of the mindset that I think it's absolutely spectacular, so I love having it in my collection. I'm really happy to have that. And then the Vetiver, the Eau de Toilette from Guerlain. This is such an underappreciated, underrated vetiver scent. It is absolutely exquisite. You can find tremendous deals on it. Obviously, I've worn it a ton. I wear this a ton. It's probably one of my most worn vetiver scents. It works really well in my environment. Gorgeous, gorgeous scent, you guys. I love this so freakishly much. These next ones are kind of along the lines of the grab and go variety. These ones are beautiful. They work very well in a variety of different occasions, morning, night, formal, casual. And generally overall, they're very just beautiful, borderlining classic scents. Mon Guerlain is one that you guys know that I sold and that I repurchased because I loved it. Beautiful scent. I don't really need to get too much into that. Then I have this one right here, which is a newer one to my collection, which I've been meaning to get, and it's Eau de Parfum of Le Hair Bleu. Now I do want to pick up a few more. I'm going to try and see if I can find an older bottle of this, but this is a beautiful, beautiful scent. I do love it, and I wear it a lot. And the next are the only two ones I have from the La Petite Robe line, and so we have Black Perfecto. I did a review of this more recently, really good. And this is the La Petite Robe Noir. I think this is the Couture one. Beautiful scent. I love this as well. I love this whole lineup. I just haven't gotten around to picking up all the bottles, all the flankers of it, but it's just a really spectacular, beautiful, ultra feminine wearable collection. I'm gonna go into the more higher end versions of Guerlain. Firstly is Gourmand Coquine. This one is probably the most impeccably beautiful, sexy chocolate fragrances ever to be created. Love this one so much. A lot of people love it. Rightfully so. If you like chocolate scents, if you want something sexy, you cannot go wrong with Gourmand Coquine. And then I also have Angelique Noir. This is a beautiful scent. I think I reviewed this like a year ago. I don't wear it a lot because it can be a little heavy in the weather that I live in, but I do miss it when I don't wear it. It's gorgeous. And then last, which was one of my like unicorn scents I was looking for, I finally got my hands on, and it's Iris Ganache. This one is the older version. I know that I believe that they reformulated it. I want to get my hands on a bottle of that so I can kind of compare and contrast. I need to review this scent for you guys, but this is one that I have been tracking down, and I got lucky, and a friend of mine had a backup bottle and he swapped it, and it's everything. It's everything, absolutely everything. It's so worth the hype. I love it, it's so good. So those are the like higher end Guerlain, but I kind of wanted to spend a little bit of time on the Aqua Allegoria line, because that's the one that I actually, even though I love like Gourmand Coquine and Shalimar, those are the ones that I think a lot of people really gravitate towards, and also the ones that I find I wear the most. So I wanted to spend a little bit more time on those. Now, I only have 8 from this line. I do need to get more. But what I love about the Aqua Allegoria line, if you're unfamiliar, they are in these bottles, is that these are really accessible. You can find these on a lot of different websites for really affordable prices if they're still in production. When they go discontinued and can't get them anymore, the price jacks up, and rightfully so, because those are fantastic. But the one that I love about these is the fact that they are affordable, they are wearable, but they're still really beautiful. Now, before I go really into it, there is one problem with this line, and I do agree with it, and it does have to do with longevity. The longevity on these fragrances is not good at all. When I wear these, I do expect to be reapplying throughout the day. And these scents are along the linear line, so you can reapply. They're not really developing, but I don't mind. You can find some of these for like $15 to $20 a bottle. So you're not spending a lot of money if you're finding these from discount sites or like on eBay or things like that. So I tend to be way more forgiving of the longevity with these scents. Now there is one that does last a little bit longer than the others. The other thing too about this line that I really like is they're all really layerable. You pretty much layer any of these with any of these just about, and they do work really well to be layered with other scents if you want to brighten it up, if you want to make it a little bit sweeter, a little bit more floral. These do work really well as great layering, just like if you love to layer your scents, getting a few of these fragrances is perfect. The first two I'm going to talk about are actually my least favorite from the line, but I still really love them. And it's Rosa Pop and Flora Rosa. These are really beautiful, very feminine, youthful scents that tend to be a little bit more on the sweet candy, syrupy, jammy side, which I actually like. But when it comes down to jammy florals, I do like there to be a little bit of complexity in those scents, and these are not very complex, but that does not mean that they are not beautiful and very wearable. So these are my least favorite of all the Aqua Allegoria, but does not mean that I do not love these and rock these. Now, ones that I tend to wear a little bit less frequently, I'm trying to find them, they're like all right in front of me, but I still love so much. I don't mean to like look and like not, and like I'm not trying to ignore you guys, I swear. All right, so these three are the ones that I don't wear that much, but are still very beautiful. So we have Pampaloon. Some people say that this has a very cat ammonia-like smell to it. I don't get that on my skin, but that does not mean that that should be discredited, and there's a lot of people that say that. I do love Pampaloon, but I do prefer to wear this layered with other things, so I don't reach for it as much, but it is really beautiful. Then we have, I think it's Lis Soleil. This is a beautiful, warm and sunny scent, but still very bright and wearable. I don't know why I don't wear this one more, but I do love it and I do enjoy wearing it. And then the other one from this lineup is Mandarin Basilic. I think that's how you pronounce it. I really love this aromatic citrus scent. It's so good. I think the reason why I don't wear this one as much is because generally if I want kind of like a citrus scent with like an herbal aromatic undertone, I go for Clementine California from Atelier Cologne. But this is still really, really beautiful. And then the last three are the ones that I wear the most. And there is definitely a category of 1, 2, 3. So Neroli Bianca, or Nerolia Bianca, is one I wear a ton. This is one I will take with me when I travel. This is the one that I will wear if I'm running errands. I don't know if you can see, but I've made a little bit of a dent in this bottle. It's just a really beautiful, very feminine scent, and it's just very fresh and perfect for Florida. And then next up we have Herba Fresca. I love mint and fragrances, and this is no exception. This is a really beautiful, true to mint smell. It just smells so, so good. I am like obsessed with this scent, and if they ever like couldn't get my hands on it, I'd buy like so many backup bottles. It's ridiculous. I love it. But the winner when it comes down to Aqua Allegoria scents in regards to the one that I reach for the most, the one that I love wearing more than the others, and also the one that I think if you were only to purchase one of these fragrances and you wanted to layer it and wear it on its own, most definitely this scent, and it's Limon Verde. This is such a beautiful scent. It's a smooth, bright citrus scent. And it's just got this like playful sparkle to it, but it's not like a fizzy, very astringent citrus scent. What I like about this scent is that this scent goes so well with a variety of different fragrances if you want to add a little bit of brightness. Even if there are scents that maybe are a little bit too heavy and you wouldn't quite think that you want to layer Limon Verde with or another fragrance with, like think of like some specific gourmands or some specific ouds or things like that. Like I love citrus and oud. I mix this with so many of my oud scents, and if you guys want a video of that, I will get into it. But the thing is that Limon Verde, I think, is the most versatile scent. It's the most used scent out of my Aqua Allegoria fragrances, and it smells good on its own. It's really powerful when layered with other fragrances, and just generally this is the one I reach for and gravitate to the most. I do have two bottles of this. I do wear it a lot. So that is my Aqua Allegoria line, all of my Guerlain fragrances. And yeah, that is my Guerlain collection. Now there is a variety of different scents I want to add. I definitely need to add the vanilla scent. I always say double vanilla spiritus or spiritus double vanilla. I always say it wrong. I need to add more of the robe collection, La Petite Robe fragrances. I do love them. I want to add more of the kind of harder to find discontinued Aqua Allegoria scents, and Mon Precious Nectar, that one is just absolutely surreal. I need to add that one to my collection as well. But that's it, guys, and that's my Guerlain collection. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. I'd love to know what you guys think of Guerlain in general as a house. Do you think they're overhyped? Do you think they're underappreciated? Do you love them? Do you have a Guerlain collection, or do you just like think, nope, don't want any of those in my collection? Let me know in the comment section below, guys. I'd love to know what you think. If you guys like these types of videos, like these longer, chatty, kind of sharing my collection videos, kind of giving you a window into what I collect and why I collect, make sure to give this video a thumbs up. It lets me know to continue doing videos like this. And also don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the little bell so that you can be notified when I have new videos come up. I generally put out videos Monday through Friday, so I'll always have something for you to watch. And as always, guys, I hope you're all happy and healthy and have a great day, month, year, whatever. And I'll see you next time. Bye.